Hello, YouTube. And we have another bee video for you guys. I've been watching my comments, and I've been told that I need to wax my frames. So I already had a couple pounds of beeswax that I bought off of Bob Benny down in Georgia, I believe it is. And I just waxed all these frames. You just use a crock pot, an old crock pot. This one's been in the basement for a long time. Cleaned it up, put a pound or two in there if you don't have any. If you're a new beekeeper, this is the way to, you know. And I wish I would have known this before I started, and I would have coated all my frames, even the ones that were pre-waxed, that apparently they use like a paraffin wax and your bees don't like it. So I got some good, I know this is good wax because I got it off of Bob Benny. So I just coated all these frames, and I'm gonna tear into the hives, and I know what I'm gonna have to do once I get some of the boxes off, because I don't have enough frames. The ones that are bare, that don't have any comb built on them, I'm going to end up running back in the garage here and coating all these frames. So it's going to be a mess. It's going to be hard to make a video, but I'm not going to be bringing the camera back in when I do the frames. But the beehives will be open, so I can't dilly-dally. But I just want you guys to see, you know, this is what I call them cabinet rollers. They make a nice finish if you're trying to make, you know, if you're rolling paint. It's a 6-inch, and this is foam. I'm going to throw some pants on, go out to the hives, open them up. Anything that doesn't have any comb, I'm gonna bring in here and I'm gonna recoat it. Anything that has wonky comb, I'm gonna get rid of it, bring it in, and re-wax it, and we'll see what we get. My clover's still doing pretty good here. I have bees all through my yard. I ran the sprinkler, and the bees are just like pretty fierce in there. They're really doing a good job as far as the clover. It must be producing some decent nectar, because I have honeybees and those little tiny bumblebees. It's just buzz central. So you gotta watch if you're in flip-flops, or, you know, yeah, you gotta be careful when you're walking so you don't step on them. So stay tuned. This will be different, exciting, hopefully informational. People say re-wax your frames. I'm gonna re-wax my frames. It is Monday, June 19th here in Pennsylvania. The honeybees are still into the clover. So they are, they're all over here. I scared them away. Trust me though. They're liking it. There's one. One, two. I see two bumblebees. There's another honeybee in it. All over here, guys. I did cheat and threw the sprinkler in a couple areas to get some water on my grass, and my neighbors probably aren't happy, but just in that frame there was three honeybees on this clover. So looks like we're gonna have a lot of clover honey. Hello YouTube, here I am getting ready to add some newly waxed foundation as suggested by some of my subscribers. I believe it was 65 small guy, and there's another individual that comments quite frequently on mine, and I appreciate it. I don't always have time to answer this stuff, but it's really appreciated, the time you guys take to leave comments and advice, because I take it, you know, because I'm new at this. So at any rate, we're going to hop into the original colony. I'm going to go through them. Any frames that aren't drawn out, I'm going to put my newly waxed frames in. I only have like 7 deep frames, so probably what's going to happen is I'm going to end up at some point having to go back to the garage and re-waxing some of the existing frames that's in the colonies, because I don't have enough. But I already did 2 complete supers, so let's see what we get into. Stay tuned. Hopefully this view's good enough. The sun is pretty good here today, so we are going to hop into this hive. Hopefully we can get this done in short order. This is definitely my best hive. It's my original package, and there's a lot of bees in it. They're probably going to be irritated with me here, but as you can see, I've left the lid cracked just to let some of the heat out, because they were bearding severely. So we'll pull in here a couple of the supers here, see what we got going on. I didn't smoke them yet, but I know they're gonna be mad. And this is kind of what I'm figuring. So what I wanna do here is see if there's anything going on in this super. And if there isn't, which I don't think there is, we are going to remove said super and add my waxed. Yeah, there's nothing going on here, which I was told to remove it, but I figured if nothing else in the summer, it would give them more room for heat and such. And they're just hanging out here, just trying to stay cool, I think. So that being said, they're starting to build this one out just a little, but there's nothing in it yet. So I'm gonna pull this off and give them a shake. And then I'll probably need my smoker, because at that point I'm gonna really make them mad. Okay. Let me readjust you guys a little bit. We're down to the second brood box that I added, and we definitely have, they're pulling frames out here. So what I'm going to do here is pull out one by one here, and I can see there's something going on here. Oh goodness. Yeah, they're drawing that out. They're drawing that out nicely. All it's a little wonky, but it's all drawn out, so this side's much better. And this is all pollen. They got this so smashed, it's got the insert here is bowed, because the way they build it. Moving over to frame number 2. I'm probably gonna need the wax soon, or the smoker. soon. Gentle, gentle, gentle. Don't roll the queen. They're drawing it out. I think I actually waited too long. This to me all seems like... It's just honey. They're putting honey in their second... in their second deep right now. When I get in the middle, I'm sure I'll probably find some eggs then. Said this colony's doing better drawn out than my nuke that I just got. When I say just got, that's been a month. But these are some gentle creatures. There's no, definitely no, I haven't even smoked them at all yet, which I probably will soon. Oh, there's some brood. Gonna be careful with the queen now, so. Yep, larvae all over with a little nectar on the top. I try to keep all this. I'm planning on melting it down because I just went through a good pound, probably plus, just... Sorry if you guys were off frame there. Just trying to make sure I don't see a queen. There's definitely evidence of her being here. So, look at that, guys. Honey on top. There's your larvae. A couple of them are capped right there. Taking a look here. I think they like their hive being open. It is 85 degrees today here on June 19th. Bunch of brood. Man, you gotta be careful when these frames get tight like this. I'm just afraid of rolling your money maker, you know? So I'm gonna raise this up a little bit so you guys can see this a little better. It helps me. I don't have to death grip the frame as much. A lot of brood. Honey in the tops. Wow, look at that, guys. You see this? You see how crazy that is? How deep this is? Look how deep this frame is. Do you see that? It's so thick right there. I'm not sure what they were thinking there. There's larvae and everything in it. So, and that's why I was having a hard time getting it out. But look how wide it is. I don't even know. Quite how I'm supposed to get it back in there, to be quite honest with you guys. All right. I'm gonna go grab my smoker quick. This hive didn't really, it just needs its super put back on. I don't see where, I'm not gonna be able to do much here. I'm not planning on running a queen excluder of any type, so. Yeah, that guy I'm talking. All right. Let's try to continue where we left off. Well, they like to talk when you do that. They're like, no. Ooh, goodness gracious, this frame weighs a lot. A lot of brood. This one's definitely ready for its second super. This package from Robert House is freaking banging it. There's a lot of honey in there, but this is their honey. Unfortunately, this is almost half full of honey. It's not all cap, but it's on its way. If you see Miss Queen, let me know. I'm terrible at spotting her. I am a colorblind guy, and I have problems with, like, even though it's marked, I can't see it. I've seen her before, and she's probably in the bottom box. And I see evidence of her, so, like, it's, I don't get too concerned that I don't see her, so. I don't know if I'm going to drop into the bottom, honestly. Like, I don't know if there's a reason to drop into the bottom one. So. It's so calming. This is so fun. People wonder why probably people do this type of stuff, but guys, this is fun. This is fun for me. It's very calming. Bees are pretty amazing creatures, if you haven't already figured that out. So, well, yeah, don't do that, guys. That's how you get stung. Comb was a little tough. Nice. Every day I get in my hive, I wonder, is today the day I'm going to get whacked? Because I've been pretty fortunate, and I haven't got it yet. I know it's coming, because, you know, it's part of the deal, you know? And I get it. I'm not a sissy. It's not like, if I was that worried about it, I wouldn't have got into this hobby in the first place, but... they're just starting to draw this one out. If the frames would have looked like that, I would have replaced them, because I have some deeps that I was planning on doing that with. But this hive has exploded in the last 2 weeks. There's going to be a mess underneath this one, I can tell already. Goodness, this is heavy. And as hard as that was to get off, I knew... It's all honey on that side, working on it on that side as well. There's no evidence of Miss Queen being in this deep, so this is going to be their fuel source for the winter. So it is. quite sure. Miss Queen is down in the bottom, like I said before. I'm not even gonna bother with them, so. Ooh, we may. Nope, they're already drawing it out. And they already have nectar stored in it, so. Nope. I'm not gonna use any of my deep frames on this box, but I'm pretty sure I'll need them on the next one. If I'd have just gave them a little more time, I just thought they could have used the boost. That's why I re-waxed those frames, but I'm sure they'll appreciate those ones in that super that I did for them. I follow a YouTube beekeeper. His name's the Bug Farmer. No. He has some pretty neat hives based off of a new design. Here's my freshly beeswaxed super. All of these frames got a fresh coat, and I wasn't lacking. I went through a pound, and I did two, and you can see, I didn't screw around. The bees are already on it. I just put it there. You can see the beeswax there. It's thick. You don't have to put it on thick, but I just happened to. So we're gonna see what we have here. I think they're gonna love it. I'm hoping. This is probably gonna piss them off, but I need to try to get these bees down into I wondered when I was gonna get whacked the first time. It was right there. I put my, you know what? Get down in there. Get down, calm down. That's not. I must have put my thumb on one because it got me right there. Right there in the old thumberoo. So, that being said, I have some high hopes for this. There we go, something like that'll work. You know what happened? I felt them bumping me in the hands, like they were letting me know, and it was too late. I'd already apparently got my thumb on one. We'll take it. YouTube, I shifted gears into my nucleus that is almost a month younger than my package. So pull that frame up. As you can see, they don't have anything going there. They don't like that one for some reason, so we'll set it aside. We'll move into this one. It's got a lot of something going on. See, I'm uninterested in that. This is what they got going on in the frame beside them, so I'm just gonna let that there right outside of the hive. Let the bees pick that thing dry. This is the hive that really got me wanting to figure out what's going on with my comb, because they're going crazy here. So you can see that's full honey. that's completely full of honey. So I don't know. At this point, holy crap. It just looks like at this point, I just let them go because they're building comb on top of comb and things don't even make sense. You know? Like, how do you let that go? I guess there's no larvae in it, so you can just let the bees repurpose it, I guess. It's kind of what I'm thinking at this point. And I'll throw some of these super frames in. Because there's just too much there. I'll let that one go. But that sucks because this whole side's good. You know? They don't like that one for some reason. And then you got this one here. I might be a little too late to take care of some of these, but other ones like this one here, we're good. We'll let them repurpose that one as well. And I'm gonna drop some new wax frames in. Hopefully they can do what they need with these. I was hoping, you know, there's gonna be some robbing going on, I'm sure, but this is what I was seeing and I just wasn't digging it too much, so. I guess we'll, dang it, I wish I could get some wax on this frame. That queen has no intentions of coming up here, and I don't blame her, because her bees don't know what the hell they're doing. Something's wrong. So I'm gonna drop some new frames, some of my wax frames in here. And a lot of these are older, and some of them don't look too good, but they're gonna love these things when they start. They're gonna love the smell of this wax. And it's heavy, heavy wax. And this should bring that queen up once they start drawing onto this, because I think this might be the ticket. So hopefully you guys can still see what I'm doing here. The ones I took out weren't terrible far along. There is some honey in them, but you know, let's just drop this other old one in. So what's that give us? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 10, but I'm telling you, they've used every square inch of that 10. And now I'll put one of my new honey supers on. My newly waxed honey supers, put it that way. And then what I'll do is I'll let these bees, they're gonna love this. Thanks for the tips, guys. That I can tell already. Sorry for disturbing you girls, but I needed to there we go. There's a lot of bees outside here. Hopefully the queen's not there. But there's a lot of honey there to be had, I guess you should say. So kind of plan. This keeps a lot of the water out, but this also keeps the bees from feeling cramped, so to speak. And I'll throw the straps on these two, and then we're gonna jump into our other one that is our swarm catch. Okay, welcome back to my swarm box. This is the third and final hive of me adding my waxed, my new wax frames too. These girls have an upper entrance, which I don't really think they use. Well, they're pulling out some of them. Let me see what we got going on here. Like I said, some. It might be easier to just pull it off and see what I got going on. Because there's a little bit there, but there's absolutely nothing in any of it yet, so I don't feel bad pulling this out yet. Let's see what else we got going on in this box. It's looking like I'm just gonna change. Yeah, I'll change this super out for another one. Pretty sure. Nothing going on in it yet, which is fine because this is a newer colony. They're just starting to draw it out, so, or well, I won't say just starting. There's nothing really in it yet. Barely any bees. So, that being said, we'll move down here. I still have two deep frames left. This is an 8-frame box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is an 8-frame box. You can see there's nothing going on there. So we'll set that frame down. Nothing going on here. We'll set this frame down. Nothing going on here. Now here's where we run into a problem. I only have two frames that are. Yeah, all these are gonna get re-waxed. So I'm gonna have to take a pause, shake the bees off, bring them in the garage. And they're just trying to do that one. I might as well just do them all. They're not being happy here, which I get it. This whole box needs done, so does the super, so. Pandemonium in the Mad Mike apiary. I'll have to find a better bee name, because I don't, see, they're just starting to draw that out. And they don't have anything in there yet. So I caught this one just in time. So. Now these two are in business of some sort. Not really. Same deal. They're all over them. There ain't nothing in them though. So this whole deep could go. But the problem is trying to get the bees out of it. Now this one's got some weight behind it. You go, girls. Look at that. That frame might have been already drawn out. I don't know, but holy crap. That ain't no joke. So we got one, like, no joke drawn out frame. Like, for real. That's weird. I'm betting you that one was an older frame that was already drawn out. Sorry about that. I have another 8-frame set up. Actually, 3 of them, actually. So what I'll do is put the cover on here temporarily and then wax some frames, and I will be back. And hopefully these other bees that are on these frames will just abscond and go back in the hive. I mean, I would think that's what they would do. So, because there's nothing here. There's nothing to keep them here. So, we're gonna go in the garage. Okay, you too. I have started to incite a riot here, apparently. So I'll have to be careful here. I don't get whacked. But there's robbing going on because of that frame out in front of the nuke on the left. So I waxed
the deep frames that I needed. So I'm gonna pull this top off here. And you can tell I'm at the end of a Mad Mike video because my gloves are all shot. This will calm them down though. These are some good smelling frames that we have for them today. Come on. Trying to calm some stuff down here. None of these bees are going about their business right now. Got bees flying around the frames I'm trying to put in. They do smell good, so. Hopefully this kickstarts them off. I went through 2 pounds of beeswax, of Bob Benny's beeswax. So I know it's not mixed with paraffin or any other junk. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I tried to space them evenly on the ends. Boy, there's a lot of room there. This gives, you can almost put 9 frames in this. Okay. So we have one extra deep frame. And then we're gonna place our honey super on. I completely waxed this whole new honey super for him as well. So put this here. And then we will put this here. Because I don't want these girls getting too hot either, so we're going to leave the cover cracked a little bit. It hasn't been raining around here enough to cause an issue, so here we go. We'll lay that guy right there, trying to give him some shade to go to, and then I'll come up here the next trip out here, and I'll gather up these frames. If a smart guy would actually probably move them a little farther away from the hive. Notice I said a smart guy would. I think I will. I'll put them in the shade over here. Yeah. Don't drop the frames, Mike. I'll throw my straps on here. This is getting pretty ballsy because they're not happy with me. Okay. I'll spin you guys around so you can see my ugly mug in closing. And we will do some sort of a follow up on this. I'll give them 2 weeks. I'm not going to bother them next week. I really disturbed them today. And the fact that I only got stung once, which is my first time, by the way. But I actually had my thumb on top of a bee, apparently, or right next to one. And it got me. Because I was carrying one of the boxes down off the first hive. And it got me. So, that being said, stay tuned. Here in a couple weeks, we'll have a follow-up of this. And see if they're starting to draw up into that new foundation better than what they were doing with that Tetris looking wonky comb. So stay tuned, watch the next one. Peace.